demand has gone double and triple, and at the same time our funding resources have declined, so our staff is way overworked.
I think we're lacking in getting that advocacy work done and that promotion and PR that we need to get out.
You know that I could use somebody.
In times of economic difficulty, policy changes are made that start eliminating things from the bottom up. So all the prevention and early intervention services are sort of going away, and the focus is primarily on the most challenged, severely emotionally disturbed, the most sick. And while that's good, we're really concerned about the bubble that's going to happen later. Because
we've got overcrowding, doubling, tripling up, while cities and counties are passing ordinances against families living together.
If the recovery continues to be slow, when do agencies and agency personnel just start burning out?
And the other thing that is always been an issue here in San Diego County is the tremendous sort of disparity between the social justice issues around people who are in need of assistance versus the attitude that people have around people needing assistance.
We have the County Office of Ed that provides some tutoring, some after-school programs, but the students couldn't get to the program.
There's been success in bringing together diverse groups to better serve the needs of the poor.
And the real question is, where's the next echelon? Where's the next group? Where are the next leaders of our social service agencies that are going to be providing these services to the people who are in so much need going to come from? We're hoping they're going to come from people like students of Cal State San Marcos.
We need structured access to student volunteers and interns with limited restriction on what we can ask them to do, because sometimes we'll put together a job description and then we get them and that's very different. But having caring young people who are energetic and resourceful that we can sort of move in to help deal with some of the triage was good.
It takes a lot of time to get somebody into the system and trained, and if they're only there 16 hours and they're off, it's almost a burden on the organization.
I just think working with university, partnering with different organizations, and everybody coming together just to work on these solutions that we as a whole can accomplish.
And where the interns have really been helpful is that because I cannot hire any more staff because of reduced funding, they jump in there and they are able to provide the manpower that we need, both as role models, and they assist in tutoring, they assist in working with the pre-kinder all the way through high school students.
Somebody.